Question number 16 here is a composition of functions. So this will be sort of what we did in number 15, but more in a forward direction. So the first thing with a composition, the one that's closest to the x is what gets plugged in first. So the h function gets plugged into the g function. So let's go ahead and first rewrite this over here. So what we're doing is g of h of x. Oops. Do it this way. Yeah. So we're going to take the h function. And everywhere there's an x, we're going to plug it in. So g is the receiving function, it's the outside function, so really that's what we end up starting with. Let's just go ahead and do it in black. So we're going to have x, which I like to rewrite as a big open parenthesis. So this is a place that's ready to receive input. So that's x plus 6. The denominator, we have x plus 3. And this is just a nice big open spot waiting for the input of 4x plus 1. So everywhere we have this open space, we're going to put in 4x plus 1. 4x plus 1. And then we're going to remove the parentheses and combine like terms, simplify, all that kind of stuff. So this, there's no exponent up here, there's no multiplication in the front, so we can just remove the parentheses. We get 4x plus 1 plus 6 in the numerator, 4x plus 1 plus 3 in the denominator. We can combine the numbers, which are like terms, so 1 and 6 is going to be 7. So 4x plus 7 over 4x plus 4. And that is our function that we put here. Now, when we want to talk about the domain of the input function, there's two things we have to look at. So domain is what x can we put in. So we put in a value of x, it first will go into the h function. And so that's the first thing we need to examine. The h function has no problems. When we're talking domain, there are two problems that come up. One is division by zero. The other is a negative inside of a square root. Well, there's no square root and there's no fraction. There's no denominator with a variable in it. So h has no problems whatsoever as far as domain. The domain here is from negative infinity to positive infinity. Okay. Second thing we have to look at is our final answer. Is there any place is there any value of x that would cause this denominator to become equal to zero? So we can see we do have a rational function. We have a denominator with a variable in it. So what we have to do is we have to check where does... So if we're looking at the domain, we're looking where is 4x plus 4. What value of x would make that equal zero? We don't have to worry about the numerator. The numerator can be zero. We can divide into zero. We just can't divide by zero. Okay, so then we would subtract 4 from both sides. Oops, don't need an equal. Subtract 4. So we get 4x equals negative 4, and then we divide by 4. So if x were equal to negative 1, we would have division by 0 in the final result. So our domain is going to be, let's go ahead and clear this stuff out. So it's going to be everything except negative 1. And the way we write that, we go from negative infinity to negative 1. But we don't include the negative 1. And then we union that with negative 1 on the sort of the right side of negative 1. This is the left side. Negative 1 is right here in the middle. It's left out. It's left out. And then we go all the way to positive infinity. So that's going to be our domain there. Let's clear it up and we'll move on to the next.